Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is module number 5, Sequencing Model, and lecture number 1 in the 5th module. We are going to discuss about the sequencing model and solution, and we will solve problems in the sequencing modeling. And in this lecture, there are different types of sequencing models, and in this lecture we will be discussing on processing n jobs into 2 machines, and we will be solving problem in that particular model. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the sequencing models. Sequencing model. What is sequencing? As an engineer, we have many engineering processes, machining process, or packing process, marketing process, sales process. There are different engineering processes. In each process, there are number of jobs, number of activities, and each job or each activity, it should be done in a proper sequence, then only the task will be completed or the process will be completed. So the way in which we have to do the operations in a particular order, that is called as sequencing. So it is the selection of appropriate order in which number of jobs or number of operations can be assigned to a finite number of service facilities. Finite number of service facilities like machines or the equipment. So we have number of jobs. Each job or each job or operation is to be assigned to a particular machine or particular man or particular equipment. So in what order we have to assign a particular job to a particular machine, that is what the sequencing model. So the ultimate objective of the sequencing model is to optimize the output in terms of time, cost or profit. So it may be minimizing the cost of operation, or minimizing the time, or maximizing the profit. So optimizing the output. So the time required for completing the task, or cost involved in the product, cost involved in the manufacturing of a particular product, or number of man hours, or amount of profit involved by completing the operation. So all these things. If it is a profit, it is maximization of the profit. If it is the machining cost, it should be minimization of the machining cost. If it is a time, we have to minimize the time. If it is labor hour or man hour, we have to minimize the man hour. So depending on the condition, we have to prepare, we have to find out a schedule. Schedule as sequencing, that is what the sequencing model. And a common sequencing rule, so FCFS, first come first served basis. So this is applicable for certain jobs. So, job process in the order as they come to the shop. And SPT, shortest processing time. So, the job with the minimum processing time will be given priority. Job with the shortest process time are scheduled first. EDD, earliest due date. So, this due date, depending on the due date, we can sequence the, we can select the process, select the job and do the operation. But majority of the time, we will do FCFS, first come, first served basis. And the features of the points that we have to remember. So, if there are n product to be processed in m different machines, or m jobs assigned to m different machines or man. So, the number of theoretically feasible solutions are n factorial to the power m. Numerically, to understand, we must select technologically feasible solution. So that must satisfy the restrictions in the processing among the theoretically feasible solution. So to understand the number, suppose there are n jobs, n equal to n product or n equal to 3, n 3 jobs, and the machines, there are 4 machines, then the number of feasible solutions are 3 factorial to the power 4 equal to 1296. There are 1296 operations, methodologies are possible, but we cannot try everything. We have to identify the theoretically best, technologically feasible, theoretically best solution sequencing model, so which will satisfy our requirement. So minimizing the cost, minimizing the time, maximizing the profit or minimizing the man hour. But the one sequence will give the minimum total elapsed time, and the sequence is called as optimum sequence. So among the various operations, various options available, one sequence will give the minimum total time or maximum profit. That is called as optimum sequence. And here we have one term called elapsed time. So the time between start of the first product and finish of the last product. So time between the beginning and the end of the activity, end of the job, that is also called as elapsed time. And a mathematical method. So what we are going to hear in the, to find the sequencing method. So the mathematical method given by S.M. Johnson used to find the sequence. So there is no theoretical proof for the S.M. Johnson method. So this is, he invented the method out of experience by doing different types of sequences, and he identified a mathematical methodology to solve the problem, solve the new type of problem. So there are n product or n jobs to be operated in m machines are allotted to m workers. So that is what the basic model. So we will see the Johnson method for solving the sequencing type of problem. There are different types of sequencing models. Sequencing problem, we take only four problems to solve in this lecture series. The first type of model is processing n jobs in two machines. The second type of model is processing n jobs in three machines, and processing two jobs in m machines, and processing n jobs in m machines. So these are all the different types of problems we are going to deal with in this lectures on sequencing model. So first model, processing n jobs in two machines. So the assumptions for the model, only two machines are involved. The machines are named as A, B, or any number we can have, but basically we take A, B is the name of the machine, and each job is processed in the order A, B. So every job is first processed in the machine A, second it is processed in the machine B, and then it is delivered. So this is the sequence of processing the job. The processing time for the job 1, 2, 3 up to N. There are N different jobs. So the processing time in machine A, it is A1, A2, A3, AN up to AN. And for machine B, in the machine B, it is B1, B2, B3 up to BN. So these are all the basic points that you have to remember. So there are the order sequence of machining is AB. So first every job is to be processed in the machine A first, then machine B. So we have the time given. And you look at the table. So it represents the table. So job 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to N. So machine A, the timings are A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and AN. Or for machine B, B1, B2, B3, B4, BN and B5 and BN. What is the solution procedure? So the first step 1, examine the column of processing time for machine A and B and find the smallest value among them. So we have a set of values for machine A and machine B. We have to find the smallest value among them. Then if the smallest value falls on the column A, that is first column, process the job first in the machine A, and if the value falls in the column B, process last on the machine A. So when the minimum value falls on the column A, we have to do the operation first in the machine A. If it is falls on the column B, we have to do the process last in the machine A. Since the sequence is AB, AB is the process. AB is the process. AB is the, what do you mean by AB? So first job is processed in the machine A, then in the machine B. If there is a tie, select either of the smallest processing time. Suppose there are two jobs of the same timing, then you take any one. There is nothing wrong. You can take any of the two jobs. Cross out the job assigned and continue the process till all the jobs are assigned in the particular sequence. So first step, you have to identify the minimum, allot the job with the minimum time with the machine A, or whether this is in the first column or the second column, depending on the availability of the value, you allot the timing, then cross out the row and continue the same procedure again and again till all the jobs are assigned to the in a particular sequence. So we try to understand the sequencing procedure of the first model with an example. Example number 1, a set of data given below, determine the sequence that minimizes the total elapsed time for 5 jobs. So there are 5 jobs A, B, C, D, E, and there are processing time machine 1 and machine 2. And the processing order is first in the machine 1, second in the machine 2. That is the ordering of the processing. Machine 1 and machine 2, that is the order. And the timings are given for machine 1, 5, 4, 8, 7, 6. For machine 2, 3, 9, 2, 4, 10. These are all the processing time in hours for job A, B, C, D and E. So, we will find the solution for the problem using the Johnson's method. First, examine the processing time of the column. So, there are two columns processing time, and it found that the minimum value is 2 for the job C and the false in the second column. So, this is the minimum time. So, 2 is the minimum, is the time which is available, which is falling on the second column. So, process the job last in the machine 1. So, what is mean by last? I prepare the table. I prepare the table and this is process, machine, job C is processed. So, because the first job what is available here, that will be processed the first in the machine 1. Then the second, this job will, so when the complete, when the job is completing machine 1, then it goes to the machine 2 and next to the machine, next job is allotted to the machine 1. So, now the job C is taken up last because of the lowest time, it is taken up last in the machine 1. Then remove the row. So, we have to delete the row. So, after deleting, you have only 4 jobs left out now. And again, we repeat the table again. We have 4 jobs with the proper timing. Once again, examine the processing time of the 2 column. The minimum time is 3. Minimum value of the minimum value is 3 for job A, which falls on the second column once again. So, this is the 3. Once again, it is falling on the second column. So, we have, again, we already we have C. Now, we have to process A prior to C. So, A prior to C. So, delete the row. So, deleting the row, we have to, we have only 3 jobs left out now. Once again, we examine the timing. So, we have now the examination process time in the 2 column. The minimum time is 4 for job B, which falls in the first column, and for job D falls in the second column. So, there are 4, 2 different values. So, 4, here again 4, here also 4. So, this 4 falls in the, for job B, it is falling on the first column. For job D, it is falling on the second column. Now, this is the order. So, D is processed earlier to B, earlier to A, and B, it is falling on the first column, it is processed first. And only one job is left out now. So, we have to take the, in the middle, after B. So, job B, job E is processed after the B. So, now this is the sequence. So, what is the order? So, machine 1, machine 2. So, job B is taken in the machine 1. Once job B is completed, job B will go to the machine 2 and job E will be taken to the machine 1. Then, once job E is completed, so then it is going to the machine 2. Then, job D is taken. Once the job D is completed, it is taken to the machine 2. Then, the job A is taken to the machine 1 and it is processed. And once A is completed, it goes to the machine 2 and job C is taken in the machine 1. Once it is completed, it goes to the machine 2 and the cycle is completed. Now, we have to find out the total elapsed time. So, this is the original table what is given in the problem. Now, this is what the sequence B, E, D, A, C, that is the order, optimum sequencing order we identified. So, B, E, D, A, C is the order. So, machine 1, machine 2. So, this table you have to find out. So, from the table we can identify the total elapsed time. For job B, so the, for job B, for machine 1, the total time is 4. So, it enters at the 0 time. It takes 4 hours in the machine 1. Once it is completed, so the job goes to the machine 2. Again, at the time, end of the 4th hour, it goes here. Then it is processed and the job B, the process time here 9. So, 4 plus 9 equal to 13. So, for job B, the total time record is 13 hours. So, 4 hours in the machine 1 and 9 hours in the machine 2, the total time is 13 hours. And coming to the machine 1, once the job B is completed, then job E is taken up. For job E, the time is 6 hours. So, after 6 hours, the job is completed. So, 4 plus 6 equal to 10. Then for job E, the time record in the machine 2 is 10. So, 10. Actually, here the job is completed, but the machine is not free. Machine 2 is not free because it is undergoing Job B is undergoing the process. So the job machine 2 will be free after 13 hours. So once the job 2, machine 2 is available, the job E is taken up and it is processed for 10 hours. So after 23 hours, it is being delivered from machine 2. Then next is machine D. For machine D, look at here, 7 hours. So 10 immediately, this is second job D is taken up here. So it is processed. So the number of hours equal to 7. So 10 plus 7 equal to 17. And it, at 17 hours, the job is completed in machine 1. But the job is ready, but the machine 2 is not ready. Machine 2 is available only after 23 hours. So after 23 hours, this is taken up here. Now the time required for the machine job D is 4 hours. So 23 plus 4 equal to 27. Now next job is A. For job A, in machine 1, it is 5 hours. So 17 plus 5 equal to 22. So at the 22 hours, job A is completed in machine 1. But it has to go to the machine 2. But machine 2 is not available. Machine 2 is busy with the previous job. So at 27 hours, the machine 2 is available. Then it is processed for 3 hours. So 27 plus 3 equal to 30. Then finally C, job C, the operating hours 8. So 22 plus 8 equal to 30. So now the job is entering here because the machine is also available. So 30 hours, machine 2 is also available. So immediately the job C is taken up in the machine 2. Then the time record is 2 hours. So 32 hours. So the job B starts with 0 hours. Job C is completed in 32 hours. The total elapsed time is 32 hours. Total elapsed time is 32 hours. But the idle time for the machine 1. What is the idle time for the machine 1? Look at the machine 1. Fourth hour, 0 hour, it starts 0 hour, it completes 30th hour. So 4 hours, immediately the second job is taken, it is processed, immediately the third job is taken, it is processed to 17 hours, then 17 hours, immediately the job A is taken, it is processed up 22 hours, and again, immediately it is job C is taken, and it is processed in 30 hours. But all the sequence will be completed by 32 hours. So the machine 1 is idle for 2 hours here. So 2 hours is the idle hour. If you take machine 2, initially it is idle for 4 hours. So it is not processing. First job is processing the machine 1. Then and only it comes to the machine 2. So it is waiting for 4 hours. Then, so it is completed 13 hours. Immediately the next job is taken. It is complete. Second job is completed in the 23 hours. Immediately the third job is taken. The third job is completed 27 hours. Immediately the fourth job is taken. The fourth job is completed in 30 hours. Immediately the fifth job is taken and it is completed in 32 hours. So the idle time here, it is at the beginning 4 hours. For machine 1, the idle time is at the end 2 hours. For machine 2, the idle time is at the beginning 4 hours. So this is the answer to the problem and this table is the answer to the problem. So this table you have to prepare after completing the optimum sequencing. And you have to prepare the sequencing, calculate the elapsed time and idle time for the machine 1 and machine 2. We take example 2, find the sequence that minimizes the total elapsed time in hours to complete the following jobs on two machines M1 and M2 in the order M1, M2. Find also the idle time for the machine 1 and machine 2. So there are 5 jobs A, B, C, D, E and there are 2 machines M1 and M2. And the processing times are given here 5, 1, 9, 3, 10 and for machine 2, 2, 6, 7, 8 and 4. Now the examine the table, the solution methodology, examine the table, the minimum time is 1 hour for the job B which falls in the column 1. So process the, so it is here, column 1, it is 1. Process the job B first in the machine M1 and cross out the row. So we have to be process first in the machine M1 and cross out the row. So we remove the row and now the jobs are available A, C, D and E. Now we examine the table again, processing time. The minimum time is 2 hours for the job A. So here we have the 2 hours for job A which falls in the second column. So process the job A last in the machine M1. So here last value we have A. Cross out the row A and we have only 3 jobs. Now among the 3 jobs, we have to identify the time. We have to find out the minimum time processing time and here 3 is the minimum processing time. So 3 is falling on the column 1. So So the column 1, we have to already we have machine B, job B. So next to job B, we have to process the job D. So that is given here. Now we examine the process time. The minimum time is 3 hours for the job D, falls in the column 1. Process the job D next to the job B in M1, cross out the job, the row D. Then we have C and E. There are only two jobs. Now once again, we have to identify the minimum time. So the minimum time is 4 hours here, which is falling on the, for job E, which is falling on the second column. Now in the second column, already we have machine A, job A. Now we have to process the job E prior to the job A in the M1 and cross out the E. Now finally we have only C, and the C is processed after the D. So the sequence is B, D, C, E, A. So first job B is started, then job D is started in machine 1, then job C, job E and job A. Once job A is completed in machine 1, then it goes to the machine 2 and the entire cycle is completed. Now this is the table, original table given. So the 5 jobs with the processing time, and this is the processing sequencing table. So B, D, C, E, A, and first job B is taken in machine 1. It enters with 0 hours. We have 1 hour processing time. So it is completed first hour. Then it goes to the second machine. So it is processing time is 6 hours. It is completed by the first 7 hours. B, job B is completed. So job D is taken next to the job B. So at the end of first hour, so job D is entering here. So 3 hours is the processing time. So 4 hours outlet out, it is coming out by 4th hour. Then it goes to the machine 2. So the machine, in the machine 2, the 8 hours is the processing time. So 7 plus 8 equal to 15. Then job C is taken at the end of the 4 hours. Job C is taken for machine 1. It is 9 hours. So 4 plus 9 equal to 13 hours. So the machine is, the job is completed by 13 hours, but the machine 2 is not available. So machine 2 is available only at the 15th hour. Then it is entering here and then processed for next 7 hours. So 15 plus 7 equal to 22. So this is leaving the machine 2. Then job E is next taken up. So at 13th hour. So the processing time is 10 hours. So 13 plus 10 equal to 23. So 23 hours. So it takes only 23 hours, but the machine is free. So machine 2 is free by 22 hours. Now the machine is waiting. So machine is waiting for 1 hour. So at the 23rd hour, the next job is taken up. And here the processing time is 4 hours. So 23 plus 4 equal to 27. Then finally job A is taken. So here 23rd hour, the job A is taken, where the processing time is 5 hours. So 28 hours. Now the job A is completed by 28th hour, but the machine is already free. So machine is, the machine process the earlier job by 27th hour. 27th hour machine 2 is free, but the job A is available in 28th hour. So 28th hour the job A is processed in the machine 2 and it is completed by 2 hours, so 30 hours. So this is the final time. So job starts at the 0th hour and all the jobs are completed in 2 machines in the 30th hour. So the total lapse time is 30 hours. The idle time for machine 1. So machine 1, look at the machine 1. 0th hour, it starts from the 0th hour, 1st hour, immediately the 2nd job is taken, 4th hour, immediately the 4th, say 3rd job is taken, 13 hours, immediately the 4th job is taken, 23 hours, immediately the next job is taken, 28 hours, then it is waiting for 2 hours. So 2 hours the waiting time. For idle time for machine M2, so look at here, 1st to 1 hour it is waiting, so there is no job, 1st to 1 hour it is waiting, plus 7 hours, immediately it is taking the job, 15 hours immediately is taking third job, 22 hours it is completed, but it is waiting for 1 hour. So 22 to 23, 1 hour is waiting. Then 27 hours, the fourth job is completed, then again it is waiting for 1 hour, 28 hours. So the idle time for machine 2 is 3 hours. So this is the solution to the problem, answer to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and there is one book, Operation Research, published by Anuradha Publications. You can refer to the book for additional problems in the sequencing model, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject, or if you want notes also, you can write to my mail ID. I will send the notes for the subject. So we'll meet again with the remaining model of sequencing problem, and we will solve the problem in the sequencing models.